The relief that you see here is a lithophane. That is an artwork that becomes visible. Let me show you when illuminated from the back. So this relief will be this nice image. Well, this is a flat lithophane. Imagine what would happen if we could wrap this lithophane around a simple plastic pipe. You can do this using the DeskProto CAM software. In this project we use a rotation axis, so we will start the DeskProto version 7 multi-axis edition, as their rotation axis is supported. We won't use the wither this time. We immediately start a bitmap project, as we want to use bitmap CAD data. And the first thing it asks is load your CAD data. Our JPEG file is on the desktop. Here it is, two kids rotated 90 degrees. The rotation is needed to get it aligned to the correctly aligned to the rotation axis, which is along X. You can see that the colors have been changed to black and white, as in DeskProto we need gray values in order to convert them to Z heights later on. Okay, here we are. The image is at 300 dpi. It's 111 millimeters times 74. And well, let's continue and define the part that we want to machine here in the part parameters. And the first thing we need to do is use a rotation axis, which will change a lot of settings. Okay, and we can see now the image is wrapped around a cylinder. DeskProto has calculated the diameter of this cylinder, 35.33 millimeters. That means that our complete image of 111 millimeters exactly fits around this cylinder. However, the pipe that we have is a larger cylinder of 70 millimeters in diameter. So we go back to the part parameters, go to material block, and set that to custom. So instead of a radius of 70.67, we enter a radius of 35 millimeters to get to our 70 millimeters diameter. And a minimum Z needs to be changed as well. Our material is 1.5 millimeter thick, so the minimum Z value is 33.5 millimeters. Okay, here we are, a much larger cylinder. Here is the 1.5 millimeter material thickness. And as you can see, the image nicely covers half of the pipe now, which is perfect, so we don't need to change the size of the image. I do want to change the length of the pipe though, otherwise the light source will be directly visible, so the pipe needs to be a bit longer. So we go back to the part parameters, to the material block, and I want to add 25 millimeters on both sides. So from 0 I need to enter minus 25, and I'll make this 100, adding in fact 26, but that's okay. Here we are, a much longer cylinder. Let me make it translucent to get a bit more clear image. Well, and this is the lampshade that we want to machine, a cylinder pipe with the relief over there. So let's see what more needs to be changed in the part parameters. This is okay. The bitmap size did not need to be changed. The Z settings are very important. Obviously, how deep should the relief be machined? Well, as said, the material thickness is 1.5 millimeters, so minus 2 definitely is too much. White needs to be lowest, obviously, for the thinner the material, the more light can pass. So, and we find that at minus 1.2 for white and minus 0.2 for black is okay for this lithophane. Material block, we already set that. Ambient does not matter. The zero point needs to be changed though. Normally for rotation axis machining, the zero point, the Z is zero, is with the tip of the cutter exactly on the rotation axis. Let me show it a bit better. Here, this blue cube is a 0 point, so it's here with the Z on the rotation axis. However, for this pipe, for this lithophane, it's easier to have it on top. So on the machine, I can touch the material, the pipe, and then say Z is 0. So in the part parameters, 0 point, I select make top of block 0. You can see that the blue cube shifts and now exactly is on the outside of the surface. Okay, we have defined our part. This is what we want to machine. And the next thing to do is set the operation parameters, the actual milling parameters, which is done in the operation, bitmap operation parameters. The cutter, we want to use a conical cutter with a bullnose tip, the same as used in the flat lithophane video. Here we are. Precision is 1/10 of a millimeter, both the distance between the toolpath and the step size along. Feeder rate needs to be a bit smaller for this very thin cutter. And the spindle speed needs to be higher. However, for this machine, we can only set that on the machine. Strategy along x-axis, so toolpath go in this direction, is okay. Roughing is not needed because the -1.2 millimeters is so shallow, the cutter can do that in one pass. Area, I want to change that. It's now the material block, so the complete pipe would be machined. I want to limit that to only use the bitmap data. Borders is okay. On tap page movement, I want to change the dynamic feed rate control, especially for the first toolpath. There, my very thin cutter needs to remove material over the full width of its tip, so that's definitely a high chip load, and I want that first toolpath to be much slower than the other toolpath, 10% of the feed rate. Here nothing needs to be changed as well, so it's okay, and we can calculate the toolpath. Here we are. Well, not much can be seen unless we zoom in a bit, and here you can clearly see that for white, the cutter removes a lot of material. Here are the white stripes. The very rough image here is only because of a quicker display. The actual image is much more detailed. So here we are. These are the toolpath, and the final step is to save these to an NCP file. Already a test file is there. I'll just simply overwrite that, and it will save our toolpath. Yes, and the final step is I can estimate the machining time. It's 1 hour and 40 minutes. We'll see about that, but we're ready with DeskProto, and we proceed to the milling machine. Okay, here we are at the machine. All has been set to start machining a piece of pipe of the correct length. It has been fixtured into special fixture tools. The axis 0 has been set on the left edge of the pipe. Y is 0, is its current position exactly above the rotation axis. All that needs to be done is set the Z is 0. As you can remember, we have set the Z is 0 with the tip of the cutter touching the outside of the pipe. So here is the old trick. We put a piece of cigarette paper and we go down in very small steps until the paper is stuck. Yes, here we are, it's stuck. So the current position is Z is 0. Let me confirm that. Here we are. Yes, remove the paper, and now we should be all set to start machining. So let's do it. With DeskProto, it's very easy to add some text below the image. So let me show you how this is done. We use vector information for the text. This can be, for instance, the names of the two children, but I'll use the DeskProto logo that is present as one of the sample cat files. So in the recent file list, I can open the project that we just made. Here is the lithophane, the pipe-lithophane with the two children. And in order to add some text, I need to load a vector file. The files were on the desktop, so here we are. This is the sample file DeskProto logo. And you can see it's a bit difficult, but here is the word DeskProto. So first it needs to be rotated 90 degrees, and that can all be done in the part parameters. As you can see, we now have two sets of part parameters. We had the bitmap settings that we just used, and now the vector settings have been added. You see the number of tabs and the names of the tabs are a bit different. On transform, I can add this rotation, which is minus 90 degrees. And oh, it keeps warning me it's not needed here. And now it's nicely horizontal. However, it's not yet aligned with the image. It's also a bit too large. So I go back to the part parameters. I scale it to about 80% of this size. And the alignment with the image can be done with the panning option. And I press this nice help align, and I align it to the center of the bitmap data. Okay, let's see what happens. And now we're here nicely in the center of the image. So for Y, for around the cylinder, that's perfect. For the X direction, I have to change a bit more. So when I change that to zero, it will be nicely here on the border. Let me show that to you of the image, but it needs to go to a minus X value in order to get it below the image. So I found minus 17 is a nice, so here is a text nicely just below the image. Okay, in order to create toolpath, I need to add a vector operation. Here we are. I need to select, let me start here. Same cutter as we just used, this tapered thing, also a bit slower, 50 millimeters per second. A depth of half a millimeter is sufficient for a readable text. All the movements can be a bit lower, and this is pocketing. I want to have all material inside these curves removed, so that's pocketing. Select all curves, offset. The step over needs to be a bit smaller, as this is a very as I want a smooth surface, and I want to start at the inside so that the outside will be as smooth as possible. So that's okay. Well, let me make that invisible so that I can calculate toolpath for only the vector operation. Here we are. You can see exactly what we need, toolpath in the text. And when I save that as an NC file, two kids, and then text. It's one too many. Text. Here we are. When I send that to the milling machine, we'll see what happens. Back at the machine with the new NC file loaded. Well, the zero point has not changed, so we can start machining immediately. Thank you. last step in this process is to create a base for this pipe lampshade to stand on. I've created this 2D DXF drawing imported in DeskProto. I'll quickly show just the toolpath. Here are the toolpath profiling toolpath for the first, for the inside, here for the outside. See the small difference here. When I show the simulation, quickly turn off the vector curves and the toolpath. When I show the simulation, here is the edge on which the pipe stands. Okay, these toolpath now will go to the milling machine. And here the result, a nice lampshade mounted on a lamp. So let's see what happens when we turn the light on. As you can see, a great result.